following program contains mature themes and frequent coarse language. Your discretion is advised.
Toronto! I'll say it again. I'm going platinum. I was coming cause you heard my name, but you don't know my game. Never felt my pain, can't read my brain. You read my lips, you got scared. Now don't even trip, be a man instead. Give thanks, I'm alive when I should be dead. I'm in the red cause my mind's distorted. People claiming they know me, but they only know a portion. I'ma move mountains and touch the sun. Don't get scared now, you knew this day would come. Hold your biz, all bets are closed. Fuck all you.
Rock the party!
We like the party, rock the party!
We like the party, to the Kid Rock Iron High. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Kid Rock is here. Don't forget, you can get a part of this. It is the Intimate and Interactive. So you can phone us, you can fax us, you can email us. There's all kinds of ways for you to get involved in what we're doing over here. Thank you very much to everybody for coming in downside. Thank you for everybody outside. Morris, sit down and chat with Kid Rock next. Kid Rock here at the headquarters for Much Music at the Chum City Building. Kid, thank you very much, man. Very cool.
Thank
you. All right? Thank you to everybody. So everybody came out to see you today. We've got a whole bunch of people in here, but let's do it a little different. Why don't we start off outside?
Whatever you want.
Let's go. Come on.
Your show.
We're heading outside. Well, it is for now. Going outside. Get loud. Here comes Kid Rock. It's Kid Rock.
Does yeah, it, go on here.
Does it ever get tiring, man, coming and checking all
this? What is that, the sex cushion?
Well, not for you and me, but maybe for you.
Yeah!
Any volunteers? You know what? Everybody wants to be a part of this, so we thought we'd go get a question right off the bat and say hi to Becky. How you doing?
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
What Jim Henson character best describes you?
What's that?
Jim Henson character best describes you. What Jim Henson character?
Which of the Muppets
and
are you
why?
Most like?
Oh, the Muppets.
There's lots of choices.
I think it would have to be Kermit. He got all the hoes.
Nice. Very nice. It's Kid Rock. You grab a seat. Your sex chairs. Slide over, man, and tell me a bit about your band. You got the. You once referred to them to me as the as not so not so pretty, but a hell of a band.
Oh yeah, yeah. The Twisted Brown Trucker Band. That are you talking about? Yeah.
Can we get one for the band?
Oh, you're too kind.
All right, so let's talk about the idea and what you're doing here, man. It's funny because you take a look at the image of the country rebel, the edgy, image of the rock rebel, not like what James Dean did, but in a bigger way, like what Johnny Cash did. You ever look at yourself in that same light?
Do you want to have sex with me? That's quite a compliment.
Not on this chair, baby. Not on this chair.
Man. Some pretty big shoes to fill right there. Johnny Cash, I mean, all I can say is thank you. Johnny Cash, you know, James Dean, those are all heroes of mine, so it's all about the American badass, you know?
What do you think about that, though, the recreation of the idol? I mean, there doesn't seem to be a whole lot of rock stars out there trying to do what you're trying to do.
I think more so than a recreation of the idol, I think it's important to entertain people when they pay their hard-earned money to come see a show. I'm not dissing anybody, but a lot of people sell a lot of records and they have a lot of hits, and then they get to a certain point and they get lazy and they just start flaking off. You know, I think you gotta, you know, you make the money, then you gotta really answer back for making the money and give people, you know, what they deserve. You know, it's pretty simple.
Is that ever hard for you, doing it every night? You ever get to a point where you think, oh, tonight I just don't have it in me?
Yeah, sure. You know, after like a 48-hour weekend, you know, just... doing everything under the sun, then you got to get up and play Monday night. Sure, you got a big hangover, you don't want to do it, but you still have to. It's part of the game. It's like being to work on time. You know, everybody's got a job sure. Here. They've gone in with a hangover. Sometimes it happens here, too, you know?
Cool. Well, right behind your back there, we have a thing called Speaker's Corner. And Speaker's Corner is an institution here in Toronto, institution in Canada. And what Speaker's Corner is a chance for people to come down, pay a dollar, and say what they want. Get their voice.
A dollar? I'm that cheap?
But yeah, a dollar. And it goes to charity, too. But what we did, Kid, is we have Speaker's Corner all over the North America right now, and it's all over Canada. So we're going to the West Coast, and someone in Vancouver has a question to ask Kid Rock. Look all right. Down here.
Oh, there we go.
Hey, I'm Gavin from Vancouver, British Columbia. And Kid Rock, what, in your opinion, is the greatest contribution to rock and roll?
Well, what is it, man? The greatest contribution. Are you saying it's you?
I hate to sound cocky, but I'm pretty sure it's me.
I I think the question everybody wants to ask you is, when the hell do you hate to sound cocky?
Why, what?
When the hell do you hate to sound cocky?
Yeah, man, it's about confidence, man. I feel I'm good at what I do, and I prove it every night, so I'm going to say I'm one of the best.
All right, cool. Let's take another question now to Mandy from Charlottesville, PEI, who sent in an email, and the email from Mandy is, hey, Kid Rock, what are your three rules to live by? Not their rules, your rules.
I think. Come on. I think everybody familiar with LL Cool J, right? Well, I think he said it best years ago when he said, give me the pussy, the money, and the mic, and I'm straight.
Let's just hope your son ain't watching. Let's go to the phones right now. So out of Ryan. Ryan, are you out there?
Yes, sir. I'm sitting right here, man.
What's your question for Kid Rock?
My question for Rock is, man, you recently performed live on Raw, WWF Raw, out in Vancouver. Wanted to know, man, was that business or was that pleasure? You a wrestling fan or what?
Really, the WWF, you know, it's cool, but that's Joe C right there. He's all about wrestling, so.
Man, he was on the show like 10 times, man. He seemed to be having fun there or something.
What's that?
He seemed to be having fun. He was out in the show about 5 times.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Joe C was there doing it. He's a little hurricane moving to the WWF, you know?
Man, did you get to meet the Godfather or what?
Yeah, sure. We met all those guys. Those guys hang out. Actually, those guys like to party quite a bit.
That's not hard to believe, man. Man, it's been great talking to you.
You too, brother.
Thanks for, man, that's awesome. Take it easy, man.
All right.
Ryan, thank you very much, man. Is there another TV show you want to be on? Like, you can ever see Kid Rock popping up on, you know, another program?
I've already been on the Playboy channel.
So. All right, we'll get more live music from Kid Rock in just a sec.
I can't say anything wrong here.
We'll be right back with more live music from Kid Rock. Interactive continues. Are you ready? Let's some more Kid Rock!
You know, we've been on the road for a long time, so I want to step out of the spotlight 1 second and hand it over to my band, Twisted Brown Trucker. Come on, y'all. Down blues, yeah. Mr. Jason Krause. And now you have an uncle in the music business. Next up to bat, Uncle Cracker on the turntables and vocals. And of course, 3'9" with a 10-footer smoking all the tweeds, Mr. Joey C. Kid Rock, I'm from Romeo, Michigan. Now let me tell you something.
I got a little secret that I want to share with you, but really it's no secret at all. So I'm just going to say it flat out. I like to eat pussy, okay? Now, a lot of fellas always ask me, they're like, Rock, how do you know when you're doing it right, man? How do you know when you hit the G-spot? I got to tell them, man, haven't you ever heard that sound? Haven't you ever heard that girl say? And they're like, what? What are you talking about, man? I'm like, come on, brother. You know when you hit that G-spot, because when you hit that G-spot, you make that girl scream out loud. She'll say,
well, 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 well.
Can you hear me?
I was a low class living, raised out of the stick. I was born to be rich. And you got love to spend. I saved up the world, honey. Go see my cousin Ellie May and get some good loving. Kissing and hugging on some biscuit lands. People always tell me I'm a twisted man. Still beam in my hand, who's taking this shit? I was born to be
tracks that will get your bullet in the chest. Pass the Buddha, the fucking Tahuna. Watch me rip because I'm such a slick shooter. Not engineer, but dime a dozen MC. Never was in a posse, I never wanted to be. I'm here.
First thing you know, you're walking down through the airport or through the street, somebody comes in like, yo rock, man, I love that one song you did, that ball with the dabba dabba dingy ding, that thing is bad, man. I'm like, all right, thanks, brother. And every once in a while you get a very friendly girl backstage, she's like, Kid Rock, I want to be a cow. I'm like, all right, get on the bus. But then the real question comes up. They say, Rock, what is your favorite song? What is the favorite song that you've written? I say, man, that's easy, man. My favorite song, a very personal one, wrote the first four lines sitting in cell block in Mount Clemens, Michigan. Don't applaud. And it goes like this right here. What is your favorite song? Is it about running? Is it about diving? Is it about what one particular thing are you doing in that song? And I say, I've been sitting here trying to find myself. I need to get behind myself. I need to find myself. Looking for the payback, listen for the playback. And they say that every man bleeds just like me. And I feel like no one, even when I'm last in line. I watch my youngest son, it helps to pass the time. I take too much ecstasy. Bunch of dollar bills, but I still act the same. Everybody knows my name. They say it way out loud.
price you pay to be some big star like I am. Outstretched hands and one night stands, but still I can't buy love. You know I can't buy love. You can't buy love. When it all comes tumbling down,
one more for you while we're right here. How about my people outside? Where you at? Out there. Yeah. All right, now I'm going to need a little bit of the crowd to help me, both inside and outside. And I'm going to tell you what to do. All right. Now, when I throw my left hand in the air, I want all the ladies in the house to say, "Kid, come on, ladies. Where you at, ladies? Come on." Now, when I throw my right hand up, I want all the fellas in the house to say, "Rock, rock. Come on. Where you at, fellas?" All right, now let me tell them outside real fast. Ladies, when I throw my left hand in the air, I want all the ladies in the place to say, "Kid, I want all the fellas in Toronto to say, "Rock, rock." One more time. All right. Are you ready up front? Are we ready outside? I said, "Watch my knees." Time to shoot, so we can get motherfucker, and I'm gonna get loose. Down like this.
Chance to talk, get involved. We're going to sit down and have some more words with Kid Rock next. Intimate and interactive, the world headquarters for much music. Kid Rock is here.
Hello.
How you feeling now?
American hot ass.
Badass in black, not anymore. All right, so let's see. We don't do the whole show. We saw the thing, the girls, the words, and all that. I'm asking you a question because I know that the word is you're a very, very strong family man with your kid, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Would you ever let your kid go to a Kid Rock show?
Sure, why not?
You ever worried about some of the things he may see and not get it, maybe too young?
No, I'm very honest with him, very open about everything I do with him, and I've never lied to him, I never will, but he's not ignorant. I educate him on everything I say. He knows when it's appropriate to use it, when it's not to. I think it's important for anybody, just talk to your kids. It's that simple, you know, that's what I'm trying to
do. I mean, take a look like a buddy of yours, you know, Eminem, who's right now getting in a whole bunch of trouble. I mean, especially the lyrics and the Marshall Mathers. Some people, you know, are thinking that it's out of line. Some people aren't. Would you let Junior listen to an Eminem record?
No, I wish you would have shot the kid in ICP, frankly. I hate them.
you don't mean that now.
And if my girlfriend or, you know, my wife, I'm not married, but God forbid I was, and my wife was kissing somebody, I'd probably shoot him too. I'm not condoning it. I'm just saying
just
I understand. That's what I would do. I'm not saying for everyone that's... Don't worry, kids 14 aren't married. They're not going to go out shooting their wives. They don't have a wife, so there you go.
Unless they grow up under you. So do you ever feel like you might have to, you know, realize that some things you say are going to fall on the ears of kids who maybe don't have a parent who is putting things in context for them?
No, I don't think it's what I say. I think it's how I live my life, and I have a definite balance in my life. When I'm on stage and I'm on the road, I'm definitely party. I get wild. I like to do everything that's out there. But when I'm at home, I'm a father to my son. I think... You know, when people read deeper and find out the real story, they see there is a flip side to everything, and everything in life is a balance, and I balance it out. You know, I split the party with the home life. Like anybody else that works 5 days and they go out and party Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, you know, that's what I do. I just try to balance my life, and it's that simple. You know, I think if they read deep and they find out how I live my life and who I am, I don't hurt people. You know, that's not my thing, and I don't go around, you know, telling people to do this and that, chop heads off or whatever. Yeah, I say some provocative things, and I always will because that's the way I feel and that's what I know.
Except for shooting.
Yeah. I'm just saying, well, you know, if you're going to be married, you shouldn't be cheating on each other, period. So what's it matter? You know, that should be the end of the story right there.
There you go. Let's go to the phones right now. Jeff is on the phone. Jeff, what's your question for Kid Rock?
Hey, Kid, how you doing? I saw you in Toronto there last year at the Warehouse. Great show, fabulous performance. Everything was, it was worth the money.
Thanks.
What's your question,
man? My question is coming from Detroit, the whole industry scene that's going on there right now, you mentioned Eminem. Insane Clown Posse, they have a big beef going on, Howard Stern's inciting it and that. Any feelings on that? Like, are you involved at all? Are you trying to stay away? What's your feelings on that one?
They suck.
Just that simple. Let's go to a question in the audience right now. Andrew, you're a big ICP fan, aren't you?
Hell no. No. Me and my buddy here, we just wanted to know, first of all, welcome back to Toronto. Great
Thank
to have you,
you
here. We just wanted, you're touring this summer with Metallica, and you know, you sampled their song. We just want to know, in terms of that whole mess that's going on right now with Napster and such, what do you feel about downloading music online and all that?
I'm rich, what do I care?
Hey, Amen, brother.
Do you understand
Amen.
The beef, though, that Metallica has?
I really don't even understand it. I mean, I don't even have an email address. You know, I use computers sometimes to do music, and that's about as far as it goes, you know. Maybe a little online porn or something. That's about as deep as I get.
All right, why don't we extend the technology? We talked about Speakers Corner just a little while ago. We started in Vancouver. Let's go to the other end right now, other end of Canada. Let's go to the East Coast in Halifax for Speakers Corner on the road.
Hi, I'm Joe. I'm from Halifax, Nova Scotia. Kid Rock, what is your most prized possession?
All right, well, what do you do? I just knew you were going for two, man.
My most prized possession, probably,
His son's not a possession, is he?
No, your son's not a possession. That's a whole different story, fellas. But that would be if it was considered a possession, yes. I would have to say my 67 Continental convertible, suicide doors.
You're all about the cars,
aren't you? When I first
got
some money, you know, that's the first, I always wanted a nice car, so I went out and bought that and have a ball driving my son around in it. He thinks he's the president waving to everybody in the back, you know.
Would you ever run for public office, man?
What's that?
Would you ever do public office? Because that would be fun for some and scary for most.
Could you recommend a position?
Hey, man, the Oval Office seems to have a bunch.
Hey, man, if it's all about cigars and getting Hummers, vote me in.
All right, then. Well, speaking of the style you mentioned, we got a fax that came in and says, Kid Rock, I love your style, clothes, etc. What do you attribute your animal magnetism to? Liliana from Surrey, B.C. It's from Surrey. There's a surprise. I'm just
Come
kidding.
Come on, you don't really mean that. My animal magnetism.
Joe, do you have any hair on my chest? What do you think about his animal magnetism?
Yeah, that's a big word. What'd she call me?
I think she's wondering why girls dig you so much. It's your most prized possession in music.
You want the honest to God truth? I'll tell you, it's like this. And I don't mean to diss anybody, but this is the honest to God truth. You know, when I had 100,000 records sold, I was pretty ugly. Now that I've sold 10 million records, I'm a sexy man. Yeah.
Well, why don't we take that man outside? Let's go to the window and see some more of your fans outside. Are you ready out there? Here comes Kid Rock. Pipe it up for Kid Rock. So all kinds going on for you. We have another question from the audience for you out here. What's your question for Kid Rock?
Hey, kid. You know, see, just wondering, how do you feel, like, you know, keeping it real, like, since other bands are selling, other bands are selling all, you know, like, Korn, Limp Bizkit, man, they're gone, man. They're all sellouts. You're keeping it real, man. How does it feel?
Now it's in your court.
You've been watching a little too much hip-hop, young man. I think people, you know, when you get up and breathe, you keep it real every day. And as long as you're proud of who you are and where you come from, that's called keeping it real to me. It's just being proud of who you are.
Is there such a thing as an artist selling out?
I'm sure there is on various levels, but what gets conveyed to the public a lot of times, let's be honest, isn't what's really happening behind closed doors. So a lot of people could be selling out and people could not even know it. And some people couldn't be. And, you know, it appears to people that they are. So I think you can see it and hear it in the music. And
here comes the man. It's Joe Cedars. Kid Rock, how you doing, Joe?
Good. I'm chilling.
Yeah! Welcome to Toronto. More live performance.
We're going to go suck on chili dogs.
More live performance with Kid Rock next. Stephanie, how you doing, baby?
What's up, beautiful?
You feel all right?
I feel really good.
All right, here we go, some more live music from Kid Rock.
Take you down to Dixie for 1 second here. Thank you.
take that and take your punk ass home. Cause I'm a kid rocket up and down your block with a bottle of scotch and watch lots of crotch. You can try to fun and you can stay this, but you can't say nothing. I play guitar like this. He went.
Fake shit like the Backstreet Boys. That ain't music, that's a bunch of damn noise. Fuck NSYNC, I think it gon' cast. Them little boy bands ain't kiss my ass. Britney Spears, man, she ain't said nothing. Tissy Aguilera bought me fake sweater cousin. You can roll with the fake, but be my boy. Come roll with rock, cause I'm a motherfucking cowboy. Real women come equipped with scripts and fake press. Find a nest in the hills, feel like Flint. Buy an old drop top, find a spot to pimp. And I'm a kid rocking up and down your block with a bottle of scotch and watch lots of crops. Buy a yacht with a flag saying chill in the mall. Come on, rock that bitch. I give a toast to the sun, drink with the stars. Get thrown in the mix to toss out of bars. Sister, do you wanna? I wanna roll. Top left back in the sunshine shining. Cowboy, baby.
the best. I rolled down my glass and said, yeah, this Nick, Nick, right, you're right. No kick, gone swinging first and in the flow. Call me whore, I'm the whore, with the whore, and the whore. Sorry, boy, I'm for the stare, cause I ain't right. I'm a painted town red, fucking painted white, white. Cause chaos, rock like I'm a Davis. My West Coast pussy for my Detroit players. Mac like Vegas, ball like Lakers. They told us to leave. Why they wanna pick on me? Lock me up and throw away my key. I ain't no G, I'm just a regular man. And yeah, act straight out of Compton, I'm straight out the trailer. Cuss like a sailor, drink like a my words of wisdom, suck my dick. I'm flicking my bitch, up and down that coast. And I'ma keep it on, truck until it falls in the ocean. Sunshine is shining, yeah.
Let me give my man proper introduction. A lot of people don't know the Cracker is a songwriter like myself. He co-wrote Only God Knows Why, Cowboy, Ball at the Ball, pretty much the whole album with me.
Thank you.
He does a little bit of a different thing than me, but I think you're gonna dig it. This is the first single called Yeah, Yeah, Yeah.
Nice.
It's a little funky joint. It goes like this.
Everybody, come on, clap your hands to the beat, just clap your hands to the beat,
come on, clap your hands to the beat.
Uncle Cracker, I might walk a little funny, but my walk is mean. I might stutter when I talk, but I say what I see. Don't agree with every other little thing that's proven. I do a lot of things that I shouldn't be doing. I'm ruining everything you might have had in mind. I'm a consistent, belligerent, solidified mind. Rags don't breathe, suburban star. I ain't got no money and I got no car. I might make pop and don't take much. See, I don't ride very far cause I ride on luck. I stay pretty stuck in a rut like I should and do it for the love of everything that's still good.
Don't know why I come here, but I know I'll never be. It's the only place I wanna be. Yeah, yeah.
Everybody, come on now, oh come on now, you go, you go, you go. I know a long way gone, but I ain't short-lived. I got deep, deep pockets that leak like a sieve. I give one
it on the fly. Like to ride the wave till the tide don't swell. I don't like cocaine,
but I like the smell.
I dwell in a place you might see unfit, but there ain't nothing you can ever say to make me give a shit. I stay pretty stuck in the rut like I should. I do it for the love of everything that's still good.
I don't know why I come here, but I know I'll never leave. It's the only place I want to be, yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't know why I come here, but I know I'll never leave. It's the only place I want to be, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Go Caniosis. Take a pass, be the last in line. If it takes 10 years, then I'm gonna be just fine. I saw the signs in the grass ain't green. I found love at the bottom of a bottle of bean. So come and clean, just seem so jaded. And being underrated's underrated, but I don't hate it. I stay stuck in the rut like I should. I do it for the love of everything that's still good.
I don't know why I come here, but I know I'll never leave.
Kid Rock, thanks a lot. Appreciate that tonight. Kid Rock, thank you very much for everybody coming down. Everybody outside, everybody at home, we really appreciate it. So let's end the way we began with some more music. This is Kid Rock.
Are we to play a song now? About them people outside, they still out there? Go ahead, Jimmy. Let's rock for the people out here one time.
Why? 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 Why?
When they're gonna learn, Joey, they just can't fuck with me.
Say, hey, hey.
I'm giving it back, so say,
hey, hey.
Show me some metal and say,
hey.